Mr. Mostly. You're mostly Clarence. What's the rest of you, then?
You there, sauntering about in a Jolliker original.
That's me.
Do you know the interesting thing about Canid shows?
Trick question. There isn't anything interesting about Canid shows.
Oh, but there is, if one possesses an eye for statistics. Mathematically speaking, the interesting thing about Canid shows is this. They're an exercise in futility.
Oh.
Winning is predetermined. Over time, the inevitable trend is that the race goes to the swift. Time and chance are just statistical outliers.
Hmm.
In other words, if you put enough canids through enough trials, the one with the most optimal attributes generally wins. Exercise in futility.
Why are you telling me this?
Oh, I've been told I should try to socialize more. Sharing an interesting fact is a proven method of endearing oneself to a stranger.
Hmm.
I'm an actuary, you see. Well, not entirely. The actuarial sciences are more of a passion than a profession. So I suppose that makes me mostly an actuary. That's a bit of a family joke. I'm Clarence Mostly.
Let's get some background info. So that name sounds familiar. Mostly Fine Furniture Company, right?
Yes, that's us. Mostly oak trees, too. My grandfather invented them, you know.
Trees?
Well, no, he didn't invent mostly oaks, but he did purchase the naming rights back during the terraforming days.
Right.
It's essentially the same thing.
Yeah, sure. I've been looking for you. You're the last known staff member on Project Gorgon.
Oh. Then you're not here about my monograph.
No.
It's true. I was involved with Project Gorgon, but that chapter of my life is long since closed. Listen, I don't know what you want with Gorgon or with me, but let me give you some free advice. Hmm? Let the past go. Live in the moment. Enjoy the party.
You're a bit late. Some mysterious figure already sent me a cryptic warnings.
Let me hazard a guess. You didn't listen then. And you're not about to listen now.
Were you the one trying to send me a message?
If I wanted to send you a message, I'd arrange for a notarized affidavit. Cryptic warnings and subtle threats are not my forte.
Just checking. I think that guy was wearing a hat, like a bowler hat. This person activated some kind of emergency lockdown. Any idea who they might be?
Someone with resources. Security countermeasures require a special override. Whoever locked down the facilities must have been watching you.
Mm-hmm.
Lifting the lockdown won't be easy. You'll need to send overrides from the chem lab and human inquiry. I don't have that level of clearance, but I know two people who do. The trouble is, I don't know you. I don't trust you. I washed my hands of Gorgon, and you're asking me to dirty them all over again. I'm going to need a good reason.
Something horrible happened on Gorgon. I'm just trying to uncover the truth.
I advise against trying to dig up what's been buried. Sooner or later, you're going to draw up something rotten.
Good analogy.
I want a favor from you. Do something for me, and I'll do something for you. That way, we don't have to rely on mutual trust. The grand prize trophy to the Canid Revue. I want it in my hands. Get me that trophy, and I'll give you the remaining researchers. Names, locations, as much information as I have.
What's so important about a trophy?
My Canid, Laplace, is statistically superior to every other Canid in this review. Better average sprinting time, superior gait coefficient, optimal anatomical symmetry. I didn't bother entering little Laplace in this pointless contest. He's already won on paper, you see. That trophy rightfully belongs to him.
That might be the most Byzantium thing I've ever heard.
Oh, you're much too kind. Does this mean you'll do it?
I don't have much of a choice. Yeah, I'll be back with the trophy.
Head into the main hall and take the elevator down into the maintenance tunnels. You'll find a service passage that leads up into the trophy room.
Hmm.
The maintenance tunnel is the only way up into the trophy room. Some technician barred the door shut on our end. Ask Tilda Coatsworth about it, over by the podium.
Oh, she's too busy being a... whatever she said. Before I go, there was something else.
What's on your mind?
So I found this eye.
My eye! I was wondering where I'd misplaced that old thing. It's perfectly preserved, you know. Every eye possesses unique dimensions, not unlike a fingerprint. The circumference, the shape, the color of the iris.
Fascinating.
An eye makes excellent proof of identification, assuming you don't mind removing one.
How did you lose your eye?
I'd rather not get into the details. If Spacer's Choice ever asks you to test out their new model of monocle, just say no.
Oh, God. Are we gonna need the eye for something else? Maybe we should hold on to it.
What's on your mind?
What can you tell me about Project Gorgon?
At the moment, nothing. I have a one-track mind. I can't stop thinking about that trophy. Why isn't it in my hands? When is it going to be in my hands? And so on and so forth.
Oh, brother.
You get me that best-in-show trophy, and it'll clear my mind right up.
I'll be back. Alright, so we have to talk to... what's her name? Hi again.
My goodness! Is that a Jolliker original?
You finally noticed.
If you wanted to show off, you're a little late for the Canid Revue.
Oops.
Don't stand too close to the Canids. You don't want their bladder issues all over your suit.
I managed to escape that somehow, sorry guys. I was actually here about the Canid Revue.
Unfortunately, you're too late. The review ended a few days ago. We've submitted our results to the Judiciary Committee and await arbitration. In 8 to 10 short weeks, we'll have the name of a winner. Probably. That gives us 8 to 10 weeks to file a maintenance request. Our technician barred the vault door and then disappeared without a trace. Can you believe that?
What was your technician doing in the vault?
The Musgrave Vault contracted a security consultant from UDL. They sent a technician to install a few security upgrades. Anti-dissident auto-mechanicals and the like.
Oh.
That technician barred the vault, but neglected to leave us with a way in from here. He wasn't seen leaving the security room, so I can't imagine where he's gone off to.
Isn't there another way into the trophy room? What about the maintenance tunnels?
The tunnels are guarded by auto-mechanical security. I don't look nearly boorish enough to resemble a UDL guard, so they'd probably shoot me on sight. In any case, I'd rather not step foot in the tunnels. The tunnels are for disposing of unwanted refuse, and no place for a respectable Byzantine.
Well, I can find my way into the vault for you. You won't have to dirty your hands.
Your eagerness to serve your betters is commendable. Here's a key card. It should help you get around inside the tunnels. Now, was there anything else? I'd like to get back to mastering over the ceremonies, or people might question why I have this role at all.
Nope, I'll be on my way. Got a key card. This key card provides additional access through the tunnels underneath the Musgrave family collection in Byzantium. So where do we enter the tunnels then? Clarence agreed to tell you how to lift the lockdown on Gorgon if you agree to... If you agree to retrieve the trophy for the annual Canid Revue, the trophy can be found inside the Musgrave family vault, accessible by service tunnels underneath the venue. Take the elevator down to the basement and find a way into the trophy room. Tilda Coatsworth gave you a key to help you get around the maintenance tunnels. Okay, elevator in the basement.
It It's not canid hunting I object to, it's the impropriety.
Back there.
Since when do you care about impropriety? Canid shows are unlawful, and you showed up anyway.
This is different. I just don't think we should be letting the lower class into Byzantium, even for fun.
Where's this elevator? What access from down below them? Wait. Yeah, there's no door here. Stupid railing. Oh, this door. Not completely sure I noticed it. Okay. Dark.
Keep quiet. You'll have to show me how to do that.
You'll have to watch me do it and learn. I guess there's more? Yeah. There's always more, isn't there? Runners up that way. Oh, is this the technician? Yep. Dead technician. Installation log completed. Scheduled annual sanitation and repair. Musgrave family vault. 1. Applied kindapine scented floor wax. 2. Appraised area in accordance with Byzantium aesthetic standards. See HHC Board Aesthetic and Interior Regulations, Section 33F. 3. Relocated garbage. 4. Installed anti-dissident automechanicals in order to ensure moral and civil hygiene. 4A. Note, tampering with, altering, and or otherwise disabling moral hygiene automechanicals is strictly prohibited under board regulations. 5. Delivered complimentary mint. That's the important part. So then, that's to get in there. What about here? Hmm. So the runner's up in there, or should I just go in here first? Actually, I don't know if this... Yeah, we have to go back here. This some kind of gas? Is that damaging?
Wish I could do that.
Watch the expert at work. Well, doesn't seem to be affecting us, this gas. Or whatever that is. Alright, so I guess that goes... We take that up to get the trophy, but then what's in here? Runners up trophies? Loot for us?
You're a deft hand with a magpack.
That's true. These dead canids show signs of domestication and extensive grooming. Mr. Ouch. How can we even tell that they're corpses? So this is what happens to the runners-up? They, because there's only one winner, they just die. Okay. Okay, going up. Oh, we're getting close to our destination. Can't open that.
These folks don't mind us borrowing this.
Nope. No one saw me coming out of there. Nope. Nope. Nothing to see here. Go along your business.
You'd only be letting them into Byzantium to live. Long enough for Clarence to sniff them out and chase them around.
It's the principle of the matter. Everything belongs in its appropriate place, and laborers do not belong in Byzantium.
I just think you're being rather narrow-minded. A common laborer might enjoy the chance to see Byzantium. Granted, they'd be seeing Byzantium while running for their lives with Canid Revue Trophies.
Bring the idea up in committee, if you're so adamant. I just don't think they belong here.
What lovely people. Got it.
Jolliker's outfits have been linked to a 12% increase in mild to moderate neck injuries as a result of so many heads turning.
I found dead canids in the service tunnels. You know anything about that?
Dead canids in the service tunnels? Domesticated canids? Why, that's utterly revolting.
You telling me you had nothing to do with this?
My dear friend, I would not dream of hurting a canid. Every Canid, regardless of their physical attributes, is a companion to their master. To kill a companion is a profound and unforgivable breach of trust. Hmm. I'm glad I chose not to participate in this loathsome Canid review. I will, however, take their trophy.
Yep, well, today is your lucky day.
My trophy! Look at this thing! Have you ever seen a more garish monument to the boredom of the elite?
Not since breakfast.
If only Grandfather Mostly were alive today, I would have loved to wave this trophy right in front of his cataracts. I hope you won't take it personally when I say I had my doubts about you. Nothing ever gets done in Byzantium, you see. Competent work is, well, a statistical anomaly.
Yeah, well, I'm the glitch in the equation. Well, I kept my end of the bargain. I expect you to keep yours.
Lifting the emergency lockdown requires overrides from the Chem Lab and Human Inquiry. Access to those facilities requires authorizations from two senior-level researchers.
Right.
Marion Blakesley, Jasper Lowe.
Lowe.
They went into hiding after the project collapsed, but I've managed to calculate their last known whereabouts within a reasonable margin of error.
Clarence's deductions. Olympus Orbital Pharmaceutical Station. Okay. Use statistical analysis to figure out their location? Show me your math.
I see you're familiar with my technique. I'd love to show you my numbers, but there aren't nearly enough napkins in this room.
Hmm.
After the project shut down, I had to keep my mind occupied. I worked on my actuarial tables, calculated the average lifespan of a Spacer's Choice worker, that sort of thing. I realized some of the researchers had to be alive. I ran some numbers, did a little research, and concluded that the two most likely survivors are Marion Blakesley and Jasper Lowe.
So these two researchers are the only ones left.
As far as I know, Jasper Lowe and Marion Blakesley are the only two surviving researchers with high-level clearance. If you want to lift the lockdown on the manufactory, you'll need to send an override from the Chem Lab and Human Inquiry. I'm afraid it's the only way.
I need two different overrides to lift one lockdown? Why is nothing in this colony ever simple?
I know it feels like you're being led on. What is that colorful metaphor commoners use? A wild sprat chase? Remember, this is Spacer's Choice we're talking about. Their security protocols are just as inefficient and frustrating as their manufacturing.
All right, then. I've got some questions about these researchers.
I'll tell you what I can.
What do I need to know about Marion Blakesley?
Dr. Marion Blakesley supervised the Human Inquiry and Auditing Facility. Live subjects, measuring tape and syringes, that sort of thing.
Mm.
Someone sabotaged the facility. Blakesley tendered her resignation and vanished. I'm reasonably certain she's hiding in a maintenance bay on Groundbreaker.
Really? Are you sure it was sabotage?
Well, with Spacer's Choice equipment, who even knows? Dr. Blakesley tendered her resignation lawfully, but under suspicious circumstances. If you want to know more, you'd best ask her yourself.
You're asking me to trust your hunch.
I'm asking you to trust in the predictive power of data. Dr. Blakesley may have disappeared after that sabotage incident, but the trajectory of her life was implied in her permanent record.
I'd rather know things for a fact than statistical probabilities. What about this Jasper Lowe guy?
Dr. Lowe described himself as a dazzling genius in his review. I disagreed. Of the 19 criteria that constitute the rubric of genius, Dr. Lowe only met 15. After the project shut down, corporate traded him off to Anti-Cleo in exchange for 5 lab coats. He's been transferred to an orbital lab around Olympus.
Wow. Must have been some fancy lab coat.
Oh dear. How do I explain this without using too many syllables? Lab coats means scientists. It's a colloquial... It's slang.
I know what it means.
Let's get back on topic. You'll find Dr. Lowe in an orbital lab around Olympus.
Okay, one other thing.
Certainly. What's on your mind?
Any more questions?
I'll tell you what I can. Dr. Lowe described himself as a After the project shut down, corporate...
You don't think much of him.
Our office gave Dr. Lowe and his team every opportunity to develop a drug under perfectly reasonable guidelines and generous deadlines. Dr. Lowe failed to meet our requests, and largely succeeded in using our supply of drugs to get himself higher than the mortality rate of a line worker at a Saltuna cannery.
All right, that's all I need to know.
Try to exercise caution. It's good for your lifespan.
Aw, are you looking out for me?
You did fetch a trophy for my little Laplace. Technically, that makes you my Canid servant. And by the transitive property of employment, my responsibility.
Wow.
No need to sound so astonished. Now, was there anything else?
Nope. Nice. I think we've already hit the level cap, guys. That was pretty quick. And I just recently leveled up anyway. Clarence's deductions. This complicated mathematical proof deduces, within a reasonable margin of error, the locations of Marion Blakesley, the former supervisor of human inquiry and auditing, and Jasper Lowe, the former head of the chem lab. Blakesley is hiding in an auxiliary docking bay on Groundbreaker, while Jasper Lowe can be found in an orbital lab around Olympus. That's pretty interesting. Okay, a clockwork mock apple. The testing supervisor of human inquiry and auditing was one Dr. Marion Blakesley. Blakesley appears to have retired to a secluded maintenance bay aboard the Groundbreaker. Somewhere in a rear bay of the Groundbreaker vessel, you have to begin your search there. And then the man in high orbit, locate Dr. Jasper Lowe and retrieve his means of access to the chem lab on Gorgon. After the collapse of Project Gorgon, Dr. Lowe was rumored to have been traded to a secret anti-Cleo science facility orbiting Olympus. Of the gas giant Olympus, travel there to find him. Okay. Okay. Oh yeah, character. Oh. 251.5% long gun crit chance. Wow. Does that mean I'll always get a crit? Is that what that means? Alright, well, we've got what we came for.
I've got a lot on my mind right now. Our trophy's gone missing, but I can't file an investigation because what we're doing here is technically illegal.
Huh. Yeah, I found dead canids down in the tunnels. Explain that.
Oh, don't look so cross. Those canids were put down mercifully.
Oh?
Not every canid is suited to the intense competition of our review. Some few canids display flaws that cannot be redeemed. A limp. Wall eye. Poor coloration.
So you kill them?
Mercifully. Anyway, listen. Nature is red in tooth and claw, and so are we. Competition is practically a law of the universe. I shouldn't have to explain this to you.
Could you give me a minute? Got the strongest urge to load my gun right now.
Go and attend to your business then. Arguing with you is a waste of time.
I could always just shoot you in the head, but... You know?
Thank you for participating in our confidentiality agreement. What can I do for you?
Nothing. Nothing at all. So, back to the Groundbreaker. Well, the Unreliable, and then to the Groundbreaker. I'm gonna store some stuff. How do I? Okay. I do want to try this out, actually. Lucky's gun. Now, is it true? I don't remember if we have our own machine. No, I guess not. Oh, yeah. We could sell some stuff on the Groundbreaker. Wow.
Someone has left a threatening message on your terminal, Captain. I was unable to trace its origin. Please make a note of it.
What message?
Welcome back, Captain. How can I be of assistance?
I can't hear the message?
Goodbye.
What do you mean? Do you mean my terminal? Oh, I do! New messages! We don't, like, we only get messages in the very beginning of the game. From error, origin not found. Subject, no subject. What a handsome vessel you have, little weasel. The Unreliable, registered to one Alex Hawthorne. But that's not you, is it? You stole it from him, just as you intend to steal Gorgon from me. Perhaps I should steal something dear from you in exchange. Your ship? Your crew? Your life? Fair is fair, after all.
Captain, please be informed that a canid has followed you onto the ship. He is quite harmless and falls within acceptable margins of adorability.
I was looking around, I was like, why am I hearing a canid? Okay. Oh my god. An appreciation of even-toed ungulates by Dahlia Hudson. The llama, scientifically referred to as llama glama, is a domesticated herbivore weighing an average of some 250 pounds. They are tall, friendly, warm, trusting, and delicious. What? When frightened by the sound of a passing starship, llamas produce a cry of alarm compared to a stalling engine or a donkey being fed into a wood chipper. Llamas are notably larger than, and therefore more superior than, the lowly alpaca. The alpaca is a murderous fiend compared to the lovable and refined llama. Contrary to popular myth, llamas don't have beaks. Yeah, that's true. That is very true.
I've shut off the visual feed from my ocular inputs in the captain's quarters. So you're free to disrobe whenever you'd like.
Well, I got this thing here staring at me, so it's unlikely. Graham's patch. Torn from Graham's jacket, Zora sent this to you with a note. I don't think I've ever seen this. I thought a keepsake might dull the pain, but it hasn't. Graham may have been a psychopath, but he still built the foundation for the movement I'm trying to keep alive. Maybe there was another way. I don't know. I've got to let it go. Abandon all hope for a better past, he used to say. Take it with my thanks. If you ever want a beer, stop by Stellar Bay. Z. There's our, one of our magazines, issue 1. I wonder where the other issue is, because we have 3 as well. Okay, red message, pet canid, red stuff. So, because we're familiar with the groundbreak, I think we'll head there first to look for Dr. Marion Blakesley in the rear bay of the groundbreaker vessel. We'll be doing that next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always, seek adventure.